Hi, it's Alan Edelman and Philip the Corgi, and I just want to say that a graph is a matrix, and a matrix can be a graph. And by graph, I mean a connection of nodes and edges. I don't mean like graphing a parabola like you did in high school, but linking nodes and edges like in a network. And a graph is a matrix, and a matrix is a graph. So let's take a look at light graphs. Here are some sample graphs. We can choose from cycle, wheel, complete path. Let's start with cycle. Here's a three cycle, a four cycle. I probably would have not have drawn it crossing, but there it is. Five cycles, six cycles, seven cycles. There's some algorithm that chooses how to draw it. And I think there are ways to go and play with that. But here are a bunch of cycles. And you could see that there's a matrix that goes with these graphs. This is called a incidence matrix. Basically, the ijth entry is one if node I is connected to node j. And so you can see that if you have a simple cycle, then node I is connected to node I plus one and node I minus one. And of course, there's a little bit of wrap around at the end, right? So nine is connected to one. Okay, if we look at the wheel, again, we have the incidence matrix. A wheel has one node that's connected to everybody. Hence, you could see that the first row and column, except for the 1, 1 entry, is all ones. And then you have something very similar to the cycle graph. You could do the complete graph. The complete graph gets a bit messy, but basically, off the diagonal, every entry is a one. Remember, I is connected to j if there's a one in the ij entry. So you can look at the matrix, you can look at the graph, and you can see what's happening. This is maybe a boring graph, just the linear graph, the line. The line is just this tridiagonal matrix with the ones on the superdiagonal and on the subdiagonal. I'd like to conclude by saying that to a mathematician, there's no difference. I think this is an interesting point. This is an interesting philosophical point. There's no difference between this graph, which is very visual, and this matrix, which is very tabular, right? To a mathematician, they have the same information. It says which node is connected to which node. We actually don't need to know where this is placed. We only need to know the information of which node is connected to which node. And so mathematically, the matrix format, the graph format, it's just a notation. And that just gives you a bit of insight, perhaps, as to how mathematicians tend to think about these sorts of things. What I'm not mentioning here, but you could look at, is these are undirected graphs. You could also have so-called directed graphs there, where there are arrows, in which case you might place a one only in the upper triangular part of the matrix or the lower triangular part, depending on which way it was pointing. And you can even have entries that are not just zero and one. You could actually have edge weights. And so instead of having a one, you could put edge weights, and then those edge weights can land on these line segments. Okay, but we're not getting there now. I just wanted this philosophical point that a graph is a matrix and a matrix is a graph.